So I say Anjaneth is a world fit monster. It's definitely, his birth was definitely meant to be in world. I tried it. All right. Continuing on with our Monster Hunter journey, we have a Fulgur Anjaneth to tend with, and I recently got the chance to make a better build for ice type weapons. So let's get a mosey on and deal with the newer Anjaneth and give him what's for. Low key, I kind of wish this Anjaneth subspecies was in Sunbreak, because it's a pretty fun monster to fight, if I'm going to be honest. I probably shouldn't start it here. Yeah, the Fulgur Anjaneth is a pretty fun fight, in my opinion. And it's more ferocious than, you know, the regular Anjaneth. It's like, even though I love Anjaneth, and I feel it was a great addition to the game, like, the Fulgur is probably what the regular Anjaneth should have been, as far as like ferociousness and, you know, how it can set you up with certain attacks and whatnot. Yeah, it has a lot of traps, and as you fight it, it gets stronger. Like, even though it has a rage mode, like all monsters, like, as you fight it, the nose bone rises. It's like, okay, it's mad. Then it starts like sparking, and you're like, okay, it's even more mad. Or maybe this should have been the starting Anjaneth. And the fire should have been the subspecies. Maybe. Just maybe. God damn it. Oh, I missed it. You're being weird. Get some damage. Damn, you let it chase you off? You do realize you have the type advantage against this guy. Or maybe it doesn't. Maybe it's just like, I'm an Anjanath. That's Tigrex. And I don't want no sauce. There we go. That was cool. That wasn't cool. What was that? Okay, that helps. Yeah, scream for me. I love Anjanath's roar in this game. I love his roar in this game. Like, it definitely has like a surround sound roar. So I say Anjanath is a world fit monster. It's definitely, his birth was definitely meant to be in world.
Oh yeah. Hey.
Okay. I tried it. Where are you at? Hmm. Mm-hmm. Another thing, too. Didn't want that. My demon flurry outside of archdemon mode is like, it's like super trash. Yeah, where you going? Okay. Does not want to continue this fight. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I did it. Just said, yeah, I'm not continuing this fight, bruh. Not continue this fight. Didn't roll that way at all. Just let you all know, didn't roll that way. Mm-hmm. Probably. You see something like this, it's like, I would like to live in a region like this. So quiet and peaceful. Then you get there and realize you're gonna freeze your balls off. And you're just like, nah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Let's head to Astera. There may be something we can help with.
You two. Oh, thank the stars you're here. Did my grandson send you?
Yes, sir. The chief asked us to come see if we could help.
I could appreciate that, too.
I'm thankful.
That they send you back between, like, the different bases and all that, just so you know, get a change of scenery, and that way, you know, one's not being wasted.
We started getting reports of the song being heard all around the new world. Soon after that, previously undiscovered subspecies appeared and wasted no time before starting to run amok.
Commander, I have strong reason to believe that the song is what caused the Legiana to fly across the hinterlands, and if monsters start leaving their natural habitats, it's only natural that there are other consequences for the ecosystem. I think this is all tied back to what was written on the cloth. Song and impact on the ecosystem.
Ah, yes. I've been told what was written on that cloth. It seems very likely that the Puke Puke and Paulumu subspecies were a precursor to our current troubles as well.
At any rate, I'll be sure to take meticulous notes about where all these monsters have started to become active.
Right. I'll leave you to it. Remember, I'm counting on you to help repair Celiana's defenses. Good luck.
More subspecies. Are they picking up on some kind of change in the environment?
They didn't even tell me.
Stop us.
Oh, man. Oh. I remember having to fight a Glavinus subspecies. I think I remember that. Yeah, this acidic Glavinus. I didn't have fun with this. And the Ebony Odogaron. Maybe it'll have dragon type weapons. Jeez. Surprise, it's still alive. Said we're calling the squad. Michael Myers movie. If Monster Hunter was more graphic, oh man, some of these cutscenes would be just like ridiculous. I definitely didn't do that, but it's one of the great things about World. It'll send you different ways you didn't want to go. Didn't do that. Oh, it's beautiful. There we go. Making some progress. Even though my blast is not blasting too well. Now, how did that happen? I had no stamina. I was expecting the stamina to run out. I was literally expecting the stamina to run out so I can go to a normal state. And I got... Never mind. I know why. Because this is Monster Hunter. And jankiness is part of the game. That's cool. Oh, it's not. Okay. It is not a thing. Thing is not fanging. I dodged left, but of course, who cares? Monster Hunter's just like, we gotta get our right. We gotta get our licks in. There we go. I don't even think that damage hit the Glavinus. Oh, now it does that. Now I'm out of stamina and I get hit. Because that's whoever thought that was a good idea should never, like, most likely never played a Monster Hunter game in their life. Or just doesn't like. Okay, I don't know what that was about. But it was interesting. I'm gonna die. Can't see anything. Saw that. I saw that. Yeah, let's do that. Didn't want that. Cool. Doop-de-doo. I cannot, like, this. I can't deactivate Demon Mode for nothing. You would think this is a slope. Okay, so I have a thorn pod, but this thing does thing is very vulnerable. That's cute. Oh. Fuck it. I gotta do it. I'm gonna run out of stamina. Now that's a slope, and I still can't deactivate my weapon. Jeez.
Acidic Gladness successfully hunted. Amazing work.
I just tap the button after I'm done an attack. I see my stamina running low. I tap the button and it just stays there. It's just like, yeah, so what? Stay in demon mode. Run out of stamina so the monster can hit you. That's how we doing this.
I'm keeping a record of the monsters being affected by that song.
Hello, Narga. Oh, hello. Well, apparently, you two don't like each other. Now, don't remember fighting the dark puppy. Well, dark puppy is the winner. And just tossed them away like garbage. I ain't gonna lie, that's cool. It's a cool looking shot. Yeah, that happened. And it followed up. And one more follow up. Gotta love being the test subject of a monster you never fought before. Tail seems to be a nice little focal point too. Oh, is this a ledge? I don't know. Maybe. It is a ledge, but they won't let me utilize it. what? I kinda didn't want it to go into a turf war, so I'm trying to mount it. Okay. Neato. Okay, it chased it off. That thing almost hit me. Oh, you do bleed. So it's just an auto-attack, auto-tracking piece of shit. Just an auto-tracking piece of shit. Let's get this off. Shouldn't have got hit by that. It's back already. Lovely. Where you going? This way. I should sharpen, but it's not. Oh. I'm not mad at that at all. Does not like Narga Kuga, does it? Mm-hmm. Okay. Do not like you. I still got hit. Making me feel some type of way. Look at Mad Mantles. The tail will not come off. Thank you. God. Allegedly supposed to be tired. Oh, he just... Okay. That was clearly like a middle finger to the player right there. That's clearly a middle finger to the player. How did it hit me? Mysteries. Stuck. I don't even remember when. On auto tracking. Auto tracking shit is that? There you go. Jesus.
Successfully hunted. Amazing work.
Okay, for my hard work. I appreciate that. I appreciate the hell out of that. The Dragon Razor?
Listen to me. Okay. Get going.
Operations are complete and the burner in my heart's cooking at full blast.
I don't remember.
Keep Celiana safe, pard.
I don't remember doing all that. This must have been when I stopped my last playthrough. Yeah, this must be it. But we're going to continue on our adventure in the next episode. Thank you for joining me on another Monster Hunter experience. Major subspecies down in the books. We're going to see what kind of additions we can make to our build and make it more optimal. I see a few options. I think with this Ebony Odogaron, I'm able to further advance my dragon weapons, I hope, which I desperately need, or want rather. So, we're going to get into all that in between time and come back with a stronger build so we can knock off Alcanna. So, thank you for joining me as always. Like, share, subscribe. And tune into the next episode. Peace.